हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू टुडेस वीडियो क्लासरूम। सब्जेक्ट कंप्यूटर साइंस, पेपर डेटाबेस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम। टुडे टॉपिक इंट्रोडक्शन टू रिलेशनल मॉडल। नाउ वी मूव्ड इनटू द सेकंड चैप्टर। द सेकंड चैप्टर नेम इज रिलेशनल मॉडल। इन द फर्स्ट चैप्टर देयर इज अ टॉपिक कॉल्ड एज अ डाटा मॉडल्स। In the data models, we have studied that there are the two types. One is record-based data model, and one is object-based data model. In the record-based data model, there are the three types: hierarchical, network, and relational model. So here we are going to discuss what is the data relational data model, how the data is represented in the relational model. We'll discuss here. The total chapter will give the some terminologies of the relational data model. So today, what is relational data model and what are the basic terminologies in the data model, we'll see today. So we already studied that the relational data model was introduced by the E.F. Card. He is a mathematician, is a American mathematician. So he introduced the relational model concept in the 1970s. So the main concept he was used is a concept of the relations. In mathematics, there is a concept called as a sets and relations, samithulu sambandhalu. So in the concept of relation, we used to say that there are some elements in the set A, there are the some elements in the set B. How the association is there between the elements of the set A and set B? So we can say that 1 to B, 2 to A, 3 to C, we can write like this. So that is a mathematical concept of the relations. So in the same way, in relational model, the relationship between the records of two tables are maintained, defined with the concept of the relations. Okay, a relation means a table. Here a relation means a table, or you can say that an object. An object is called as a relation. For example, if you take our college information system or college database system, so your course is a relation, student is a relation, employee is a relation. Okay, so these are all are the relations. Simply you can say that relation is a table with collection of records. Okay, next to the relational model, main objectives are three things. One is that to implement high degree of data independency. High degree of data independency, that means the application programs that are designed to access the data from the relations are independent of the data structures of the relations. అంటే మన అప్లికేషన్ ప్రోగ్రామ్స్ ఏవైతే డిజైన్ చేస్తున్నామో అవన్నీ కూడా డేటా స్ట్రక్చర్, అంటే టేబుల్లో ఉన్నటువంటి కాలమ్స్ ఏవి ఉన్నాయి, ఆ కాలమ్స్లో ఎలాంటి ఫీల్డ్స్ ఉన్నాయి, దాంతో సంబంధం లేకుండా అప్లికేషన్ ప్రోగ్రామ్స్ అనేది డిజైన్ చేయాలి. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద ఇండిపెండెంట్ డేటా ఇండిపెండెన్సీ. సో ద వన్ ఆఫ్ ద మెయిన్ కాన్సెప్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద రిలేషనల్ మోడల్ ఈస్ టు ఇంక్రీజ్ ద డేటా ఇండిపెండెన్సీ అండ్ ఆల్సో టు ప్రొవైడ్ ఏ కాన్సెప్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద టు ఇంప్రూవ్ ద consistency and also reduce the problems of redundancy. Data consistency improve ayyindanukondi data redundancy kuda decrease avutundi. So data redundancy decrease kodaniki the relational model lo there is a concept of the normalization. So then we'll discuss about the normalization in the third unit lo, last chapter lo mana discussion chesam. So these are the main impacts of the relational model. Simply you can say that a relational model is a collection of relations. Relational model is a collection of relations. In this relational model, the relationship between the two tables is maintained by using a common attribute in these the two tables. Okay, now we'll see the some basic terminologies in the relational model. The first thing is that a relation. First thing is that a relation. I already told that a relation is a table. Relation is a table. So the relations contain columns and also rows. Columns and rows. So for example, what the relation? A relations are used to hold the information about the object. About the object to be represented in the database. So for example, if you are in a college, we are the student, we need to maintain the information about the student. Now student table we have to design. Now student table we have to design. The word student is called as here a relation. A relation. Next, attribute. So what is the attribute? We say that relation is a table with columns and rows. So for example, roll number, name, father name, marks. So these are called as a attributes. These are called as a attributes. We can say that the names of the columns are called as a attributes. So but relationship lo unnatundi oka sorry relation lo unnatundi columns evithunna columns anante manaku ikkada attributes anadam jarugutundi. The table columns correspond to attributes. Attributes can appear in any order in the relationship. So first rule number raale tarvata name father name marks ee particular order follow avalsinaatundi necessity ledu. First father name raasi tarvata name raayachu. You can anyway you can write okay attribute. Next domain. The domain is a set of allowable values for one or more attributes. That means for example I given here column names, rule number, name. So what type of values can we store here the rule number? What type of can you store in the column of name? So that is called as a domain. Domain ante ikkada for example rule number column lo number store chesamu, name column lo only alphabets undali, marks column lo only numbers undali, numerics undali. So that is called as a domain. So generally mana programming terminology lo data types antam kada, ikkada relational model lo it is say that domain. Okay, simply domain is a set of allowable values for the attributes. Every attribute in a relation is defined in a domain. The prati attribute kuda we have to define what type of values can we store in that particular column, particular attribute. A column lo a type of values man store chesam, define chesam. That is called as a domain. Next, tuple. We already said that the table contain the rows also. Those rows are called as a tuple. Rows ఏంటంటే మనం ట్యూపుల్ అంటం. ఎ ట్యూపుల్ ఇస్ ఏ రో ఆఫ్ ఎ రిలేషన్. ఒక రిలేషన్ లో ఉన్నటువంటి ఒక పర్టిక్యులర్ రో ఏంటంటాము వి సే దట్ ట్యూపుల్. సో జనరల్ ఇక్కడ మనం ట్యూపుల్ అనొచ్చు. నెక్స్ట్ మనం ఆల్్రెడీ ఫైల్ బేస్డ్ సిస్టం లో దాన్ని ఏమన్నం రికార్డ్ అన్నం. ఇక్కడ ఏమంటున్నాం ట్యూపుల్ అంటున్నాం. నెక్స్ట్ ద ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ ఎ రిలేషన్ ఆర్ ద రోస్ ఆర్ ద ట్యూపుల్స్ ఇన్ ద టేబుల్. Okay, the tuples can appear in any order in the relations. And because table lo student table lo rows istunam, rows ante in the students names, students details. So student information is particular order lo ivvalane em ledhu, any order lo manamu you can mention. Next, degree. The degree is the number of columns in a table. That means the degree of a relation is the number of attributes it contains. And a particular table ఆ టేబుల్లో ఎన్ని కాలమ్స్ ఉన్నాయి. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఐ హియర్ గివెన్ 1 2 3 4 5. ద డిగ్రీ ఆఫ్ దిస్ రిలేషన్ ఇస్ ఆ 5. ఓకే, సో దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ద డిగ్రీ ఆఫ్ ఎ రిలేషన్. ఏ రిలేషన్ విత్ ఓన్లీ వన్ ఆట్రిబ్యూట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ఎ యూనరీ రిలేషన్. ఏ రిలేషన్ విత్ టూ ఆట్రిబ్యూట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ఎ బైనరీ రిలేషన్. త్రీ ఆట్రిబ్యూట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ఎ టెర్నరీ రిలేషన్. Clear? So the degree of a relation is the number of attributes in that relation. Next, cardinality. The cardinality of a relation is the number of tuples it contains. Chandi, the table number of tuples. Tuples means rows. Any rows unnai? 4 rows unnai. The cardinality is 4. 10 rows unnai. The cardinality is 10. Like that. Okay, the number of tuples is called as the cardinality of the relation, and this changes as the tuples are added or deleted. The rows add avutuntai, rows delete avuta unte cardinality anedi change avutundi. the final is called as a relational database. What do you mean by relational database? That what is database? A collection of data. Simply, relational database is a collection of normalized relations. So, we already studied that a database is a collection of data. These data are arranged in a table manner. So, here table is called as a relation. So, in the database, the data is maintaining with the form of relations, so that the database is called as a relational database. We are saying that relational database is a collection of normalized relations. So, what do you mean by normalized relations? Once we identify the objects in the organization, we have to identify that is there any data redundancy exist? Is the data any redundancy undane check cheyali. So if there is any redundancy, we need to decompose the table into two or more tables. And ekkadaina manaku data redundancy anedi manaku anpinchind ankonde tables ni two or more tables laga divide chesam. Aa process ni manamu normalization antamu. Aa normalization dwara vachina relations ni normalized relations antamu. So we'll discuss about in the third unit lo manam discussion chesam. So this is about the relational database. So when you are saying taking a relation, every relation must have some properties. The properties that the normalized relation. What is the normalized relation? Normalized relation ka properties and name. The normalized relation must have a name that is distinct from all other relation names in the relational database. Schema na database na same. Oka relational database teeskunte A2 relations iskunna kuda different names undali. Same names undadu. Next, each cell of the relation contain exactly one value, atomic value antar, single value antar. So, and prati column lo, so the intersection of every row, this is called a cell a single value undali, two values undadu. Two values endukunte sir, so for example, oka student phone number isna. Phone number and two phone numbers undachu kada, untai, marakana ala undakudadu. Range yala sir, we'll go for the normalization concept. Next, each attribute has a distinct name in a relation. In a particular relations, there are 10 columns, 10 attributes. Every two attributes have unique names, common names. And two attributes have the same name. So, that is a, each attribute has a distinct name. Next, the values of an attributes are all from the same domain. For example, rule number this kuna. Rule number column kuda numerics and kachitanga numerics say undali. Okada numeric okada string wala undagudadu. Next, the order of the next what is the, each tuple is a distinct. There are no duplicate tuples. The duplicate tuple means row. Duplicate rows anedi undagudadu. And the same data again insert cheyagudadu. Next, the order of the attribute has no significance. The order of the tuple has no significance. And order to important lekunda man rose. So these are the sub basic terminologies in the relational model. Okay. So this is about the relational model. The next class will go for the relational keys, which is important for the in the examination system. Okay, students.